Hello, my name is Elif. I make anatomy and medicine videos. If you like my videos, please subscribe my YouTube channel and follow me on my Instagram and Facebook pages. In this video, I will talk about femoral anteversion angle. Let's take a brief look at the hip joint to better understand the femoral anteversion angle. The hip joint is a ball and socket type synovial joint, allowing range of motion as a multiaxial joint. Flexion and extension, abduction and adduction, internal external rotations, and even circumduction can perform in hip joint. Thanks to deep insertion of the head of the femur into acetabulum, hip joint is highly stabilized joint. So, hip joint allows the person to perform many movements, such as standing, jumping, walking, and squatting. Because of hip joint is directly related to walking, pathologies that occur here directly affect walking. Hip joint forms by acetabular fossa and femoral head. In Latin, acetabular fossa, also known as fossa acetabularis, and femoral head, known as caput femoris, caput means head. While the femoral head is 2/3 of a sphere, acetabular fossa is half of a sphere. Acetabulum, it means vinegar cup in Latin, is a cup-shaped cavity on lateral aspect of the hip joint. It is like a socket and articulates with the femoral head to form hip joint. The margin of acetabulum is interrupted by acetabular notch at inferomedial aspect. In here, there is no socket, which is very important biomechanically. Acetabular notch is breached by the transverse acetabular ligament in here. Transverse acetabular ligament is also known as, in Latin, ligamentum transversum acetabuli. Femoral head, caput femoris, is like a ball located supramedially and anteriorly at acetabular fossa. Femoral head is more stable in the acetabulum than the humerus is in the glenoid cavity. The first reason of this is, while the glenoid cavity is shallower, the acetabular fossa is quite deep compared to glenoid cavity. Other reason is femur has a longer neck than humerus and it is anteverted. Normal range of this angle is between 8 to 15 degrees and this provides to low sufficient movement and proper alignment for movements that occur at the hip joint. Version in the femur is determined by femoral version angle. Femoral version angle or femoral anteversion, femoral neck anteversion or femoral torsion angle is the angle between the projection of two lines in the axial plane perpendicular to the femoral shaft. One of these lines is an axis running along the femoral neck. The other one is transverse condylar axis, which connects the right and left two condyles and extends transversely between these two. Transcondylar axis shows the degree of twist, torsion of the femur. So femoral version affects the gait. It is a risk factor for clinical diseases such as osteoarthritis or acellate capital femoral epiphysis. Normal degree of this angle is in between 8 to 15 degrees, as I mentioned before. Femoral anteversion is greater at birth, 35-45 degrees, and it decreases gradually with growth. So newborn hip can perform external rotation at 18-19 degrees, but has a limited internal rotation as 0 to 10 degrees. At the age of 1, it decreases to 30-40 degrees. Around 16 years of age, skeletal maturity started to complete, and this angle decreases to even 10 degrees. If the femoral anteversion angle is greater than 15 degrees, that will result femoral head being excessively rotated anteriorly. The patient will be walking with their toes turned in position, which is in-toeing gait pattern, to keep femoral head more stable in its socket. Walking in this position for long periods of time causes the hip internal rotators to shorten. In this case, it restricts the external rotation of the hip. Children with increased anteversion run with a circumduction gait secondary to internal rotation at hip. That is why generally child prefer W sits rather than cross-legged. Excessive anteversion of femoral head is compensated by internal rotation of the femoral shaft. This is seen with the introversion of the lower extremity while walking. This position not cause or worsen in-toeing in children. While skeleton getting mature, it provides enough cavity, so this angle will decrease and children will have sufficient internal rotation to allow them sit cross-legged position more comfortably. Femoral retroversion angle. If the version angle is smaller than 8 degrees, it will result femoral head being rotated posteriorly and the patient walking with an out-toeing gait pattern. It is also known as dog-footed gait. Retroversion of the femoral head is compensated by external rotation of the femoral shaft. This is seen with the extroversion of the lower extremity in walking. This is why it is called out-toeing gait. Prolonged walking in this position causes the hip external rotators to shorten. In this case, internal rotation of the hip is restricted. Femoral retroversion is usually bilateral when its origin is idiopathic. It may develop in degenerative arthritis.